But the first time I walk in the Opry, I'll be able to play it, which means a lot to me. How about that? Look at that. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
You too.
This is one for my grandfather, this first debut here. I'm gonna do it for him. This is one step, but it's quite a tremendous step for me. It's a real honor. I'm Marcus King, and this is my Opry debut. About a vintage guitar store, and this being one of my favorite ones, just everybody that works here is like a pal of mine. They're all really sweet folks. Yeah, From the Ashes is a 62-345 and cherry red that my grandpa bought in 1965. My dad gifted this to me. Tried and true, Big Red is her name. This was one of my favorite guitars. It's a 54 Esquire. They just sound so sweet, and they just sound like American music to me. I remember the first time I picked up a guitar, it was about 3. Ever since then, I had something in my hands. It's therapeutic. That's the number one thing, is to get what's going on in here, and get it out somehow. If you start writing now, there's a better chance you won't write a manifesto. I was blessed to have very good men to look up to in my life, but there were some negative representations as well. So I never saw a good way to express your feelings other than playing music. My grandfather, I'd say, would be the first country musician that influenced me as a kid. Then I'd listen to what he was into. Willie Nelson, Charlie Pride, Johnny Cash. Merle Haggard would be one of those musicians.
I'd like to settle down, but they won't let me.
My father was a rocker, still is, and he turned me on to all the old blues cats like Elmore James and Muddy Waters, but he'd also turned me on to the Allman Brothers. I did understand who I was at a young age. Once I started playing and singing and writing, really, is when it took hold. I'd play in the back room at my grandfather's house for hours, man, just playing and just letting the neck become an extension of my innermost wants and feelings and emotions. It allows me to kind of be a quasi-chameleon of all these different styles that I grew up listening to, you know?
Beautiful stranger, come here quite often.
I tell everybody that I was just blessed to be a freak and just to be able to walk amongst people that didn't really get what I was trying to say in high school. There were kids next to me that had to ask permission to use the bathroom, and a few minutes later they have to figure out what they're gonna be the rest of their lives. I still had to ask to go to the bathroom, but I knew what I was gonna be. Wow. Look at this. Hot damn. Doesn't seem real. My grandfather, he always wanted to make his way up here, and he was on his way, but he never quite got here. It's a real blessing. How you doing?
So good.
Good to see you.
So good to see you.
You want to sing one real quick?
Yeah.
Sun raised out by the river, singing sweet songs to wash my pain away.
I met Marcus. I was actually up in New York City, and I saw this young man on stage with flaming red hair playing the guitar like I'd never seen, and I couldn't decide if he was 103 or 23 because his soul is so old, and I knew that I had to know more about him.
One more.
Soul thing, it's so intrinsically connected to who he is. It's timeless music, and they're gonna love him tonight. I'm really excited to see the crowd.
He's a 23-year-old fourth generation musician. He's simply a phenomenon. Welcome, Marcus King, everybody.
songs to wash my pain away.
No words to describe the way I'm feeling. There's a lot. There's a lot of emotions kind of stirring around there. As soon as the band kicked in, man, I kind of felt confident that they were going to carry me through. I could have laid down on the ground out there. It's such a good house band, and I've got my drummer with me and my keyboard player with me. They certainly held me up.
All the places that you see, she won't stop thinking of me.
It's not just the fact that he has a great voice and just the fact that he can play so well, but it's, you believe him when he's on stage.
Anytime I get to play music is a tremendous opportunity for me, and I think it's a real blessing to be able to do that. Whatever it is that you're passionate about, you love what you do and do what you love, there's no greater feeling in the world.
Thank you so much.
You've witnessed Grand Ole Opry history, ladies and gentlemen. The Grand Ole Opry debut, September 4th, 2019. Marcus King.
Subscribe to the Grand Ole Opry YouTube channel to watch new episodes being released each week. Thanks for watching.